This is part two of linear regressions. We want to talk about multivariate regression. The goal is to understand the definition of multivariate regression, how we represent the linear regression in the matrix format, the cost function, an analytical solution, and finally showing one example. Similar to univariate linear regression, multivariate linear regression is also a model that uses a linear function to make predictions about a target value. But instead, it uses various feature functions. In the previous one, we had one feature function, but here, we have various features. So the regression function here is formulated as y is equal to theta sub 0 multiplied by 1 plus theta sub 1 multiplied by x sub 1 plus theta sub n multiplied by x sub n. If I want to compare it to univariate, in univariate, we had y is equal to theta sub 0 plus theta sub 1 x sub 1. That was all. But now we have multiple features. We have various inputs. And how we can represent this in the vector format? We can say 1, x sub 2, x sub n, multiplied by theta sub 0, theta sub 1, theta sub n. We call this vector x, and we call this vector theta. As you can see, this is the vector representation for multivariate. All right, since our data is essentially tabulated and our regression function predicts one target value for each row of the features, we can represent our entire data set in the form that is the matrix format. So let's consider y to be a column vector holding all of our target values, y sub 0 to y sub n. All right, so y sub 0 is equal to 1 x 1 1 to x 1 n. Y sub 1 is again 1 x 2 1 to x sub 2n, and so on, again 1, x m1 to x mn. So this is an m by n matrix. This is m by 1, and we have the n by 1, we have m by 1 vector of thetas. Theta sub 0, which is n plus 1, and this is n plus 1. Theta sub 1, theta sub n. So why this is m multiplied by n plus 1? This is multiplied by n plus 1 by 1. So the output of this is going to be m by 1, which is the dimension of our y matrix. So why this is n plus 1? Because we added another column here that is going to multiply by this theta zeros. So we have vector of parameters, matrix of data, and vector of target values, all of the target values. All right. Again, we can represent this in the matrix format. So y is equal to matrix A, matrix X, which is m by n plus 1, multiplied by vector theta, which is n plus 1 by 1. And y is m by 1. This is the matrix representation for multivariate regression. All right, again, we define SSE similar to the univariate regression. The cost function is sum of all of the squared errors, where the error are difference between the actual target value and predicted target value. So, for example, we have y sub I minus theta 0 minus theta sub 1 x I 1 and so on squared. So if you want to represent this in the vector format, it's y minus x theta. So the error is going to be y minus x theta squared, the norm of y minus x theta squared, or the norm of x theta minus y squared. If you want to expand this, we can also show it as x theta minus y transpose multiplied by x theta minus y. All right. So why do we do this? You're going to see that in the next slide. Because we want to find a closed form analytical solution for multivariate regression. To find the parameters that minimize the cost function, we have to find the gradient of the function with respect to the parameters and then set it to zero. So from the previous module and the previous lectures, we have learned how to find gradient in the matrix and vector format. So we want to find gradient with respect to theta because theta is the unknown parameter vector of x theta minus y transpose multiplied by x theta minus y. So first I'm going to expand this. So x theta minus y transpose multiplied by x theta minus y. It's going to be y transpose plus theta transpose x transpose multiplied by x theta minus y. So it's going to be theta transpose x theta minus theta transpose y minus y transpose x theta plus y transpose y. All right, so we are going to insert this expanded form here. And now we want to find the gradient. To find the gradient, this one leads to 2 theta transpose x minus. This one goes away because we are finding the gradient with respect to theta. And these two together will give us minus 2 y transpose x. So this is the gradient. Now we set the gradient to 0. So we have this is equal to 0. Then we can conclude that 2 theta transpose x is equal to 2 y transpose x. What did we do in this step? We simply brought this to the other side. And then what I'm going to do, I'm going to multiply both sides of this from the right side by x transpose x inverse. X transpose x inverse. So what does it give me? It gives me 2 theta transpose x transpose x multiplied by x transpose x inverse is equal to 2 y transpose x transpose x inverse. So these two together leads to the identity matrix. So they basically cancel each other. Then we divide this by 2, divide this by 2. So this 2 goes away. This is going to be our closed form solution. Our closed form for solution is simply theta transpose is y transpose x multiplied by x transpose x inverse. Again, this is another interesting application of linear algebra and how we can represent our data in terms of matrices and vectors. So here we have vector x. What is vector x? Vector x is a vector that contains ones here, as well as our data, 1, 1, x1, n, x2, 1, x2, n, xm1, xm. So this is an m by n plus 1 matrix. And we have y, which is an m by 1 vector. Based on all these, we can simply find the values for theta, for our parameters. All right, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to evaluate this dimension wise before going to the next step. So keep it till here. We know that the dimension of boy is m by 1, then y transpose is 1 by m. Dimension of x is m by n plus 1. Then dimension of x transpose is n by 1 by m. Now we want to find out the dimensions of this. So y transpose is 1 by m. X is m by n plus 1. X transpose is n plus 1 by m. X is m by n plus 1. Inverse. All right. So when we multiply these two, the dimension of the outcome is n plus 1 by n plus 1. When we inverse it, still the dimensions are the same. Now we have n and m, so these two goes away. N plus 1 and n plus 1. So the dimension of this entire thing is going to be 1 by n plus 1. Which is exactly what we want for theta. Theta was theta 0, theta 1, and theta n, which is n plus 1 dimensional vector. So dimension wise, this equation, this closed form equation for finding the values of our thetas or our parameters for the multivariate regression makes sense as well. All right, let's take a look at an example here. So we are given vector y, 1, 4, 7. We also have given vectors x1 and x2. And this one is the column that we intentionally add. So we insert this column here. We want to compute the parameters of theta such that it minimizes the error given the equation y is equal to theta sub 0 plus theta sub 1 x sub 1 plus theta sub 2, x sub 2. Using the analytical solution, we simply need to do this. Theta transpose is y transpose. So let me find out what's y transpose. Y is 1, 4, 7. Y transpose is simply 1, 4, 7. X, we already know the value, the matrix x. X transpose is 1, 2, 5. It comes to the first column, 1, 3, minus 1, 1, 6, 13. What we do, we simply insert all these in this closed form solution. And using MATLAB or Python, you can calculate the value for this. This is going to be the outcome. What does this mean? That means y is equal to, so this is theta z sub 0, theta sub 1, and theta sub 2. Y is equal to theta sub 0 plus theta sub 1, x sub 1 plus theta sub 2, x sub 2. This is the value for our y, for the multivariate function. All right, let me provide the summary of both multivariate and univariate. So univariate regression, we had vector y, vector x, and we wanted to determine theta sub 0 and theta sub 1 to make sure that we have the optimal regression. So how do we find the regression function? In this case, we found a closed form solution or analytical solution. First, we find theta sub 1, which is sigma x sub I minus x bar, y sub I minus y hat, divided by sigma x sub I minus x sub hat square, I from 1 to n, I from 1 to. And then theta sub 0 is y hat minus theta 1 x hat, where x hat and y hat are the average of input data of the given data. So our unknowns here are theta 0 and theta 1. These are our unknowns. For the multivariate regression, what we have is y is equal to theta 0 plus theta 1x plus x sub 1, x sub 2, theta n, x sub. We represent the problem as y is equal to x theta, where x is a matrix. And what is this matrix? 1, 1, 1, x 1, 1, x 1, 2, x 1, m, x 1, m, x 2, 1, sorry. X m 1, x m n, x 2 n, and so on. All right, here the closed form solution is theta transpose is equal to y transpose multiplied by matrix x multiplied by x transpose x inverse. This gives us the closed form solution. Again here, theta sub 0, theta sub 1, and theta sub n are our unknowns. All right, this was the end of univariate and multivariate regression. Again, the goal was to see how we can represent the data in terms of matrices and vectors, and how we can find the best regression that fits this data, both in the univariate and multivariate regressions.